Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at one of the new features in DaVinci Resolve 18, and that is the proxy generator. Well, the proxy generator are going to generate your media into proxies in a pretty smart way, making it way easier to work with large files. So this is extremely helpful when you are working on, for instance, multicams with the, let's say, 5-6 cameras with 4K streams to make proxies, and it's actually doing it pretty smart as well. It will generate the proxy into the folder, and in the menu, of course, you can choose in between what kind of media you are going to use for your project, and we're going to have a look into that, of course. It is available both in the studio version, which is the version I am using, and also in the free versions. However, on the free version, there are some limitations due to codecs, different codecs. For instance, if you are on a PC, you might have some problems, but of course you could buy the codecs from Microsoft and it'll work just fine. So let's go into DaVinci Resolve and have a look at the generator. So just a super quick look at the proxy generator. Again, this is provided when you download DaVinci Resolve 18, and it will work in both the studio and the free version with some different things, but I told you about that already. So let's just see how it works. It is a separate app. So let's say I have these clips here I want to do something about. So I'm just going to drag this into the generator, and it's now going to generate this, of course, into the format I want it to do. So either I can do a 8-bit in half resolution, or I can do an 8-bit in full resolution. I can do the same thing in 10-bit, and I can also do a render of a ProRes 422 10-bit. However, for a proxy, I think the default here is quite okay, so it's pretty easy. As you saw, I just dragged this in, and I'm just going to push start. And now it's going to process my clips. As you see right here, it's pretty fast compared to other generators, I think. And it's doing a pretty good job. It's going to take all of these and squeeze them down to a very noticeable size. So if I go into the map here, you can see that DaVinci Resolve has now made a proxy file. And that means that the proxy is so easy for DaVinci Resolve to recognize. So when we go into DaVinci Resolve, I can choose if I want to work with my original files, or I can go up here to the playback and go into proxy handling. And here I can, for instance, disable all proxies. So now it's using my original clips. If this is going to be a little too heavy on my system, of course, I can go up again, playback, proxy handling, and I can change it to prefer proxies or prefer camera originals. So again, I will go to the camera originals here again, and that's running fine. For other systems, I might want to change this to the proxy. And this is super easy, and you can then do all of your editing, all the stuff you need to do with your clips, telling your great story, and then before you render, you can just enable the proxies and it will render out with the originals. Again, a super nice little feature in DaVinci Resolve 18. I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.